it's obviously important to get off to a good start. But I disagree with you a little bit from the standpoint in Carolina, we didn't get off to a good start, and yet we still responded in that playoff game. So I think it's really the ability of your football team to respond to situations. That's something that we've been much better about in the playoffs. There were times during the season when we did that. It's all part of growing up as a team. You always want to start fast, but that's not always the case with these games. And if that doesn't happen, at least we feel a lot more comfortable now with our team responding and being able to handle that type of situation.
Coach, how different is Dick LeBeau's 3-4 than the other ones that you've faced this year?
Well, Dick LeBeau is one of the innovators of the 3-4 defense, and those guys play a very tough, physical, disciplined style of defense. It's one that they don't make a lot of mistakes. They understand exactly what they're trying to get accomplished, and it's very difficult to have success against them. That's obviously why they're the number one rated defense in the league. So, you know, I think that it really comes down to execution. I've gone against that defense and Coach LeBeau a number of times in training camp, and at best, mixed results. So, you know, this will be an exciting game from that standpoint to see if we can do anything.
Ken Brown, Cincinnati, the KTVK in Phoenix. Can you talk about yesterday practice, where your team is as the week has progressed? Have you noticed any sort of edge about your team as of yet?
Yesterday we had good work on the field. It was not quite the normal Wednesday for us because a lot of our plan was already installed. So it was really going back and running through some of the things that we've done last week with a few additions that we added over the weekend. And it's always good. Normally on a Wednesday, there's a lot of feeling out process, a lot of understanding what you're trying to get done. We didn't have that yesterday, so we had a good up-tempo practice. The guys are excited. You know, with everything that's gone on this week as far as their commitments to the media and those type of things, they were excited about getting back to work on the football field yesterday, and we had a good practice.
Ken, can you talk about your relationship with the fans? You've made a point after every playoff win to circumnavigate the stadium and high-five, and the importance of that connection and emotion on the field along the way.
Well, a big part of the reason that I'm standing here, that we're down here in Tampa for this game, is because of our fans. I think that we've created an atmosphere at University of Phoenix Stadium for our home games, which is very difficult for teams to come in and beat us, and it really played off for us with two of our three playoff games there. I think that, you know, it's been a long time coming for the state of Arizona, for the city of Phoenix, for this football team to have some success. We're very excited that the fans have made a major contribution for that, and we're very grateful to that. I don't think that, I came from Pittsburgh, who has a great fan base, who's very supportive of that football team, and it's exciting for me that we're building that in Arizona, and that to see it come to fruition for us in playoff games, when the most important games of the year, you know, it was a big thing for us.
Ken, you played with Russ Stroman in Washington. Could you talk a little bit about him as a player? And then did you know right away that, you know, he was going to be a coach, or not until you got back together in Pittsburgh did you find out that this guy was a pretty good coach too?
Well, I knew Russ and I had a relationship that continued after we played together as teammates. And when he decided to get into coaching after his career was over, you know, just from the way he played, he was a very smart football player. He played a number of positions at a high level in that offensive line. Always a guy in the huddle that knew what was going on, not just from the standpoint of what the play was being called, but what the defenses were doing. So you could tell that he had an ability to analytically look at the defense and understand what they were trying to get accomplished. And that served him well, in my opinion, as a coach. But, you know, I think that his mindset, the way he approaches the game, how professional he is, and that desire to win, which he's been a very successful player and a coach, is really what makes him such a special person and why he's been so valuable to our team.
Ken, you talked a few times this week about the decision to go with Kurt instead of Matt at the end of the preseason. It came down to one night when you made the decision. Can you paint that picture a little more about what that night was like and what you wrestled with there?
Well, it was a Friday night after our last preseason game, and we had a team team meeting on Saturday where we looked at the tape, and then our final roster cuts were that day, so there was a lot of things going on. And at that time, I felt I had to make a decision in order to prepare for our first regular season game, which was 8 days away. So Friday night, after that game, was about trying to make that decision. And it was very difficult from the standpoint of I liked a lot of the things that Matt had done for us in the preseason and the way that I had seen him grow and how he'd handled the competition. And obviously, Kurt had had a very good preseason, a very good training camp, and had done very well. And it was a very difficult decision from the standpoint of I knew that whoever wasn't the starter was going to be disappointed, but it wasn't necessarily because they shouldn't be starting or didn't have a chance to start. So it really came down to making the decision at the end of who I thought gave us the best chance to start fast. Because in looking at our schedule with 5 East Coast trips, which obviously we didn't do very well on, I knew it was going to be important that we started fast in our first 2 games early in the season, and we did that.